Now, this is a tricky topic, since whatever sounds you use are completely up to you, but know that there are some things to consider while doing the sounds. For one, you want to make sure the sounds match the action. The sound's pretty obvious, sure, but even some of us on animation team have had trouble picking appropriate sound effects for hits. You don't want something like this playing for this weak punch. You want to make sure that each action is conveyed properly, both in animation and in sound. You can sell what you're doing a lot easier by using a lot more sound effects. If we're talking about a fight, the first thing people think to add is hit sound effects. This is only one part of the sounds. You need swings, maybe some enhancing sound effects like bone crushing. Take a look at this animation. One of them has just a hit sound effect, and the other has a swing sound effect as the hit is coming in. You're able to follow the action a lot clearly with the audio cues, as it allows you to anticipate what's coming next. Another thing you can do is stack sound effects on top of each other. We do this all the time as well, since it can create some really nice sounds, since creating hard impact with just one sound effect doesn't always work. For example, sometimes the sound effect isn't meaty enough, or maybe it doesn't last long enough. That's where we would stack our sounds. This also works for swings, folly, and other sound effects. If you're using Flash 8, you may run into an issue where your sound effects don't play if you have too many going on at once. We're not sure why this is the case, but be mindful of how long those frames are for your sound effects so you don't run into this issue. Or export the sounds separately at the end of the animation. If you're using anything else above Flash 8, you don't have to worry about this since it's not an issue in those versions. Your main objective is to sell the things you're putting on screen, to immerse your audience in what you're creating. If you're animating something in a lively city, you want to have sounds of cars driving by, horns honking, people talking, etc. Or maybe you're in a forest full of wildlife, you'll want to have birds chirping, ambient forest noise, etc. Picking good sounds is something that's hard to put into words as is since, like animating, it involves a lot of trial and error. A lot. You may find yourself replaying the animation over and over to make sure the sounds fit, and that's perfectly fine. As you continue to animate, you'll eventually start to know exactly what you'll want people to hear that'll better represent the animation. It's something that develops over time.